H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Employee ID equals to 200. So select this and run this. You can just say F5 to run this. So if you see here, I got only about the Jennifer itself. Okay. Yeah. Saroja, this all goes in your SQL or if you join the Oracle course, probably you will be able to understand these things because this is completely on the Oracle itself. Okay. All right. So there's a question from Adil. Just so that I understand, could you... Class has an argument. Which class has an argument? You're talking about this? Yeah, this is an argument in order to see from your job, from your, if you want to run this query, sometimes you want to say 200, sometimes you want to say 186. So you have to pass some arguments to this, right? Or some value to the your where clause. The same thing I'm doing it out here. When I'm using my select query, I can dynamically change this value here. So when I change this value here, so it comes to your select query, and from your select query, you are basically passing this information here to the where clause. Okay, so this is dynamic for me. No, there is an argument, right? I have passed with an argument. That's what, if you run this application right now, I see this right now, only Stephen King. If I remove this, then I get all the information about all the employees. Okay. So is there still confusion? I'm not sure what is confusing you here. Right. If you remove the where clause, it is just a query, the normal query. I'm not giving a where clause here. You just, Saroja, do one thing. You just go with this application, run this application, and we can discuss later. Okay. This is pretty much simple. I mean, I'm just dynamically passing these values here. Okay. All right. So let's just move on. The next program is your prepared statement, and let's see what is a prepared statement. Okay. So in your prepared statement, the only thing is, if you see the difference between your statement and a prepared statement, the time. First, in your statement, you just get the statement here and then you execute query. But in case of a prepared statement, you just say connection.prepared statement. The moment you just say prepared statement, you basically write the query out here. Okay. And if you see here in your prepared statement, you say select star from employees where employee ID equals to question mark and the first name equal to question mark. Okay. You're basically giving a placeholder to these question marks. Okay. You're saying from employee where employee ID equals to question mark and first name equals to question mark. Now, where are we supposed to fill in this particular information? I'm just saying prepared statement dot set integer. Now, what is my employee ID? What type of data is that? Is my employee ID? If I go back to my database and if I expand this and just expand my employees table out here, my employee table is basically of type number. Okay, employee ID is of type number. First name is of type varchar, or it is a string or whatever. And higher date is a date. Okay, so depending on the kind of data type you have it in your database column, the same kind of APIs you are supposed to use it in order to fetch the information. Now here, as you can see here, I know that my employee ID, this is my placeholder. So I am basically saying employee ID equals to question mark. That means I have to add a employee ID. Now what type of data type is? That is an integer. For that reason, I'm saying prepared statement dot set integer. Okay. And I have to give this value, what value it is. It is very similar when you say select star from employees where employee ID equals to 100 and first name equals to XYZ. Okay. So instead of giving it, instead of hard coding the values here, I'm just dynamically giving all these values here. Okay. The same thing also goes here, but there is slight differences, which we are going to talk about it right now. Okay. So STINT, there is your set integer, there is your set string. And at last, once you are ready with your prepared statement, you just say prepared statement dot execute query. Okay. From here, everything is same the way we saw it in your statement. Okay. So we have got statement, we have got prepared statement also. Okay. So what is the difference basically is when you use your statement, what happens is each and every time this particular query gets compiled. Okay. But when you use a prepared statement, it gets compiled once. Okay. And you keep on using this compiled statement every time. Okay. But when you talk about your execute query, it gets compiled every time you hit the query. So in this case, the performance is slow, but in this case, the performance is high in case of a prepared statement. Okay. So this is a prepared statement in the sense it is a pre-compiled statement. All right. There's no other differences. If suppose you want to have some more where clauses by giving some other dynamic values, you can specify with question mark and you can set those informations out here. Okay. So this is my first index. This is my second index. So this is my first question mark. This is my second question mark. Okay. Okay. So the same thing here also, I'm just saying,
one yeah. Quick question. For the same prepared statement, can you same prepared statement object, can you say prepare statement and then later on you can say create statement on the same object and then you can reuse it?
I didn't get your question, Madhu.
Can you reuse the statement object to create statement and as well as prepare statement?
No, this is different. Okay, this is your prepare statement is a different interface, statement is a different interface.
I see.
Okay.
All right, thanks.
Okay, so here we are using connection. As we have spoken about connection, we have spoken about statement. This is a prepare statement, and we are going to talk about when we invoke the procedures also. So this is a callable statement. Okay. Now, this third program, let us see what all things. We can even create a table, as I said. So here it says, create table, let's say. Okay, so I'm just going to create a table now. That is your H2K table with table with an ID and a name out here. Okay. So what do I use here? I just say again the same thing. I use a statement out here. Okay. And once I create this, see, I do not basically need a prepared statement here because I'm just creating a table here. Okay. So I just say statement dot execute. Now, if you see here, in these cases, where are the other? So I just say execute query because I know it is a query for me. Okay. So when I say select star from employees, I'm basically querying the database. And in this case also, I'm just saying execute query because I'm querying the database. Okay. In the third one, I'm just not querying the database. Instead, I'm passing on some command to the database so that something goes with the database. Okay. So here for that reason, I'm just saying statement dot execute. So that means when I say create table name with the column details, so it basically goes and creates a table. The same thing if you just copy and paste it from your SQL developer, you can do the same thing. Okay. So as of now, if you see, there is no tables out here as H2K. Okay. So right click, run as Java application. A table got created, false. So let us go back. Where is that? Okay. So if you see, a table got created out here, and let us go and see the execute. Okay. So it basically again throws your SQL exception out here. So this is how, I mean, you can do any kind of operations out here. Basically, it doesn't matter. You can create a table, you can drop a table. There is no restrictions out here. Now, you can create a procedure also from your JDBC. So usually what happens, you create a procedure from your from your SQL developer or from any kind of database tools. Okay, so in order to create a procedure, what you have to do is you have to use something like your if you see here, okay, you just need to say execute update here, okay, and before even as you if you are not familiar with the procedure, you basically say create or replace procedure name, and this is your in parameter, this is your out parameter, okay, as begin select employee.firstname into employee name from employees emp where employee.employee equals to any of the argument which you're going to pass it out here, okay. So here if you see, I do not have a procedure in your database here. So if I just expand this, so do I have the same procedure? Show employee, okay. So the procedure is not out here. So from my JDBC application, I'm just going to create a procedure right now, okay. I can even drop a procedure from my JDBC application. So let me just execute this particular. Any questions from anyone, folks?
Yes, Jerem, I want to ask, what is a procedure?
Mm-hmm. What is a procedure?
Yeah.
Okay, procedure in JDB, in your database concepts. Now tell me, when you talk about calculation method, CL calculation method. So in your calculation method, what you do, you basically say add value and you pass on some arguments to it, right? And in return, you just get the get one result. If you say 2 plus 2 and 3, you get the result as 5, right? So what is this? This is a function in Java, wherein you're passing some arguments and you're getting some return value out here, right? The same way when you talk about in database concepts, you cannot have a function. I mean, you cannot have any of these kind of thing. You in your database, you'll be having procedures and functions also. Okay, you just invoke these kind of functions. You have some logic already present in your database. Let's say, for example, why do you need a procedure? Let's say I need some logic here. I need to query the database. Okay, so I say here I need to query the database. I need to query the employee table, and after querying the employee table, what I have to do is I need to get the information about your row number 181, row number 183. Okay, I club these two things and I want to store this information in a different table. Okay, I cannot do those things in a single query. So for that reason, what I do is I will basically need a procedure. I need a function in order to write the complete logic. So when I talk about a logic, if you see in my calculation program, I do some logic here, right? I say A equals to A plus 10. After that, I can even say B equals to B plus 5. Okay, so this is the kind of logic which I can do it in my method. So one line, two line, three line. Okay, so these things you cannot do it in a single query. Or in when you talk about your database concept, you cannot do it in a single query. So basically, you need some kind of functions or procedure in order to execute those things in one by one line. All right. So for that reason, you need a procedure or you need a function also. Okay. So these are all database concepts. Again, I'm just giving you on a very higher level. We will see even how to execute a procedure and how to write the procedure. We have already seen that right now. How to write a procedure? You just need to say create or replace procedure name, and this is your in parameter and this is your out parameter. And in parameter is something like you just give an input, and output parameter is one which you basically get an output from your procedure. Okay, so if you see in your Java program, when you say calculate something, you are getting an output from a particular program or return type from a particular program. Okay, the same thing out here, this is kind of an output which you're going to get from the procedure. Okay, all right, so in order to execute this, again, the same thing, you just say con.create statement, you get this statement here, and you just say execute update, okay? So if I run this application, right-click, run as Java application. So the procedure got created, did not put any output here. So if I just right-click, every procedure, if you just use your SQL developer, if you create a procedure, it basically goes and resides in the procedure package here, okay? So refresh this. So one procedure got created, that is your show employee. Okay, so this is my procedure. It says create or replace employee procedure, create or replace procedure names, show employee. Okay, and this is my in parameter, this is my out parameter. All right, so this is how you basically create a procedure. So let us go ahead and invoke the procedure and see what is the outcome of invoking a procedure. All right, so Just go back and let me just uncomment this one. So already I have created a procedure. Even though there is an existing procedure also, you can very well call those procedures. Okay. Now there are a couple of other existing procedures like add job history, get EMP data and secure DML and stuff and all. We can even execute those procedures by invoking those things. Okay. Now how to invoke your procedure? In order to work along with the procedure, you have to basically need a scalable statement. So we spoke about statement, we spoke about prepared statement. Now we are going to talk about your callable statement. So with the help of my callable statement, I will be able to invoke a particular procedure. Okay, so let us do that now. So call procedure. So again, the same thing, you need to connect, have a connection. From the connection, you need to say prepare call. Okay, so in your previous statement, you just need to say con dot prepare statement, and from the prepare statement, you used to get the APIs. Okay, so you have to say execute, or you have to say prepare statement and stuff. Okay, so in this case, you have to say prepare call. So when you say prepare call, you have to put something in your curly braces. Okay, you have to use a curly braces. From your curly braces, you have to say call. So this is a standard. You have to say call and show employee. And in that, you are giving two placeholders or two question marks. That means if you go and look into your procedure here, you are having two arguments to it. Okay, one is your in, out, one is your in, one is out, and even you have the other as in and out also. Okay, so once you again, as I said, if you learn your Oracle and procedure stuff, so you should basically understand what is the procedure and what are the different arguments we can pass on to the procedure. Okay, now we have two placeholders, so for that reason I'm just using two question marks. For that reason, I have to basically pass two informations to it. Okay. Now the first information is basically going to be my input. Okay. So here I'm just saying show employee of which particular employee of employee ID 100. This I can even pass it dynamically, but I'm just for the sake of giving you an example, I just hard coded this value here. Otherwise, you can very well pass it out from here itself. Okay. Now the second one is if you remember from calculation. Now, when you say calculation, when you say add value, you have two inputs and you have got one output, right? So because that's what you have it as a return type. So that's what you do. You say return A plus B. The same thing out here, in order to get an output from a procedure. Okay. So in order to get an output from a procedure, you have to basically register the output. Okay. That means you are saying that the second argument which I'm going to get, sorry, this is not an argument. The second value which I'm going to get is basically an output. The first one is an input, second one is an output for me. So I need to say cs.register output parameter. So this is my type as varchar, because I know that I am going to get a employee name whenever I pass the value as 100, okay, or any kind of employee ID. Okay, so I just say cs.execute query once I prepare all these things. These are all standards. Okay, you don't have to it is nothing, no logic out here. It's something you have to execute this. Sorry, you have to create this. Okay, and you have to set the input and output parameters. So whenever there is an output parameter, you are supposed to say out parameters out here. Okay, and cs.execute query. So the moment you say cs.execute query, you basically, this particular procedure is going to get executed, and the value what you're going to get it is here as an output in your register output parameter. So the same thing, you just say cs.getString of 2, the index 2. Okay, you get the employee name here. So if I run this application right now, let's see what's going to happen. Right click, run as Java application. So I got a value as Steven, because I know the employee ID. For the employee ID 100, the value was Steven. Now, if you just close look into this, if it says create a replay procedure name, no doubt, as begin, select employee.first name into employee name. Now, what is your employee name? Employee name is nothing but your out parameter. What it is happening, it is going and querying the database, and the first name which you are going to get is going to push it to your employee name. And this is my output basically to the procedure. Okay, from which table? From employee EMP, where employee dot employee ID equals to EID. Now what is my EID? EID is nothing but my input out here.
Jiram, I have a question. Is it possible for you to anyway like extend your view to a higher resolution, like 100% or something, because this the words are so tiny, it's barely we can barely I can barely.
Oh, these things.
Yeah, is it possible? Because on a recorded session, I mean on a web view,
okay,
it makes it very difficult.
Okay, for now, let me just copy this and paste it in the notepad. Okay, so this is your create a replace procedure, procedure name, show employees. And this is the input, and this is my output. Okay. Now, if you see, I say select employee.firstname from which table? From my employee table. From employee table, and the first name which I'm going to get is I'm actually pushing it into employee name. The employee name is nothing but your output parameter. Okay. So that is what you basically register from your Java application. Now, if you just change it to 200, I should get some other result. Run as Java application. You basically get it as Jennifer. So this procedure is basically which is already present in your database. This gets invoked. Okay. Now it is very very much similar when you say in your application you say calculation dot add value. You invoke this particular function. Okay. The same thing, you are invoking a particular procedure out here. All right. Okay. What next? Okay, so even you can
Jairam,
yeah.
Sorry, one quick question. Can we have output parameters in Java functions?
Java functions?
Yeah, can we have, we cannot have output parameters, right?
No, we do not. We there is a trick actually. You can manipulate things. Probably I can show you in the next sessions, because in Java you basically pass an object, right? So you can basically manipulate that object and you can see that. Okay?
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah, I can even show you that. Otherwise, you can just create a method. Okay, create an something like, for example, public void my details. Okay, in that try to pass a person PER. Okay, and what you do for you know from your, let's say I'm just trying to call it from here. You just say my details. And let's say you have already created a person, PER is one, person PER equals to new person, okay, with some details, let's say your SSN, your name. So what you do, you just pass this person out here, and coming out here, you say PER, now let's say the name is Jairam, okay. Come here and change the name, PER dot name equals to, let's say Jairam Routh. And then come to the same function out here. Okay. Now this is one. First I created an object, and then next I pass this object to a method. And after that, I just when I say system out SOP, and if I say PER dot name, I will get Jairam Rauth here. That means you're passing in an object out here, and that particular object you're changing the value. And again, when you print this out here, you are going to get a different value. You are going to get it as Jairam Rauth. Okay. There is a trick out here, you can even do that, but yeah, you can do that. So there is no way you cannot do it in Java. All right, you got it right, what I said here.
So for the person,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, but for the person object, that mm-hmm. input parameter, can you, within that procedure, can you say, within that method, can you say person equal to some, creating another object, assigning another person object over there?
You can, yes.
But does that reflect in the main?
You can very well do that. I mean, then no one is stopping you. You can refer this, because this is just a reference to a particular object, right? This is just a reference. Now, this reference, you can refer it to a new person, let's say Madhu. Okay, you can even do that. You can still change the complete reference of a particular person reference here.
But that reflects in the back in the calling procedure too?
No, you're talking about procedure or you're talking about Java here?
In Java here, yeah.
Yeah, in Java, yes, it reflects basically. Okay.
Oh, okay. So it's passed by reference. It's not passed by value.
No, in Java, it is basically always passed by value itself. But Java is not passed by reference. You're passing the reference, but what is reference? Reference is also a memory address, right? So it is actually a value itself. Okay.
Right, within that my details function, if you say per equal to new person.
Yeah, equals to new person. So yes, you are basically changing the reference or the memory address to which this particular reference is referring it to. Now, if it is referring it to X location, now it is going to refer to the Y location.
So if it goes back in the calling function in the system sys out, per dot name will be different.
Will be different.
And even if you say per dot to string, it also will be different.
It will be different. Yes.
I see.
Okay.
Gotcha.
So these are a few tricks. Okay. I mean, it all depends on your functionality. What functionality you want to use? You will not do it. But again, if your application is demanding that, then you have to do that. Okay. All right, so insert row in database and rollback, I'll just take up a few more minutes, folks, okay? So here you just say, okay, when you talk about your connection, you have an option saying that set auto-commit false also, auto-commit as false also. So these all goes to your transaction, okay? Now, here what I'm trying to do is, I'm just saying, let's say the table which I created, so here I'm just saying insert into H2K table values so and so. Okay, so I just try to insert something. Okay, so dynamically I'm going to give some values here. So I believe I'm passing in some values. I'm just giving a value as 28 and 28. Okay, so that is what I want to insert into my H2K table. So I can very well insert it from here. But the time I insert, I can just execute update. If suppose something goes wrong, I can basically say connection.rollback also. Okay. So as of now, let us just execute this program without any flaws. So it says execute update, and I just say invoke this, and I just say return value from insert some value. Okay. Let me even take this. But as of now, let me copy this and put it in a sys-trace. And then just add this values up here. Because again, I have to open the logger. Now, okay, I just want to say you one thing. I have executed a lot of programs, and all the programs are actually pushing all the outputs to the logger file, okay? Now, if you see here, in yesterday's class, we spoke about JDBC issue.log. Now, a new log has been created, that is again JDBC issue.log. And the previous log file has given a name as 22, okay? 2014-522. So you don't have to change it. I mean, these are all previous days logs, okay? So every time let's say tomorrow again, you run your application, a new log file gets created, okay? So just wanted to say you that. All right, so what next? Okay, let me execute this. So just as insert statement here. And I'm passing a couple of parameters to the statement here with two question marks. I just want to say what all things I would insert here. So I gave as 28 and 28 from this method itself. Right click, run as Java application. Okay. So return value equals from insert equals to 1 because one row got inserted to the database. So it is returning me as 1 here. Okay. So if I just go back and see this data, I see 28 and 28. Sorry guys, it's too small. I don't know how to change this. Fine, I'm not sure. Okay, so if I just say select star from, can I do like this? One sec, folks, I have to figure this out. Select star from